Kind of your philosophy of how you treat your guests.
Yeah, well, it's a private spa just for our guests. So we're not a day spa. We're not open to the public. So we really wanted it to be a place where it was just people coming for the experience, not people coming in off of the street.
Where are you attracting most of your guests from?
All over the country, from like Ohio to the Atlantic. So we get a lot of guests from the bigger cities, New York, Indianapolis, Chicago, Miami, and then I'd say our local guests, most of them come from within 4 or 5 hours drive. So North Carolina, South Carolina, Virginia, and Georgia.
How are folks finding out about you?
Lots of word of mouth. So we've been open for 13 years. So we've had thousands of people come through the doors. So we get a lot of repeat guests. We get a lot of word of mouth guests. And then a lot of TripAdvisors become super popular. Everybody is going to TripAdvisor to get a review of the place they're interested in staying. And then the Explore Asheville website, the website that the Convention and Visitors Bureau runs, they send a lot of guests our way.
And tell us about being part of the Asheville Bed and Breakfast Association, if you would.
Sure, that's a new thing for us. So we are new members. ABBA has been around for, I think, 16 or 17 years. And it's an association of inns. There are about 18 of them, and you kind of have to be invited to join. I find it to be really refreshing and helpful to be able to work with other innkeepers. And they do a lot. They do a lot to sort of promote bed and breakfast as an alternative to the thousands of hotel rooms that are going into Asheville and the surrounding area in the next couple of years. And they do a great job.
So typical stay, how many nights do you find they just want to chill on property? Do they take in Biltmore and some of Asheville, or is it kind of individual?
We don't have a lot of guests who actually visit the Biltmore estate. People are coming, they're attracted to the spa, so most of our guests are getting spa packages. And they find that they get here a lot of times with plans for things they want to do in the daytime, places they want to go for dinner, activities. And they end up just deciding to stay here and not do anything. And that's sort of what we are about. We're trying to promote people just kind of coming and decompressing and relaxing without schedules and without timelines and without things to do. So, and we love it when people come and they sleep in. We know we're doing a good job when people come and they say, you know, typically I can't sleep past 5 or 6 in the morning, and they wake up at even 8. Even if they wake up at 8, we feel like that's an accomplishment.
Today we're doing something called the Couples Body Melt.
The Body Meltdown is a 2-hour treatment. It integrates a lot of different massage techniques, and it's probably our most popular treatment that we do. If you've never been in a 2-hour spa treatment or body treatment, you can't really compare it. You can't compare it to an hour treatment. You can't even compare it to a 90-minute treatment. We know when people fall asleep on the table, which happens often, that it's been super successful. We do different kinds of body treatments. They usually last between 1 hour and 2 hours. We do a 75-minute mud wrap with mud from the Dead Sea. We do 60-minute massages, we do 90-minute massages, we do a deep tissue sports massage. And all of these can be done either as couples, typically that's what people like to do, or they can be done separately in separate rooms. And then we have in our facial room upstairs, we do men's and women's facials.
And they are fabulous.
Yeah, and we use a great line of organic skincare products called Eminence. They're wonderful. And then all the products that we use in the spa are organic too. Yeah, we have a meditation garden out back. It's at the back of the property. And it's a place, you know, any given week I'll find somebody doing yoga out there, few times a year we get some Tai Chi practitioners or Qigong practitioners, and they're out there doing their exercises early in the morning. It's pretty neat to see that people feel that kind of relaxed and comfortable to do things like that around the inn. And we think that's really special. It's not uncommon to go out into the sun porch and find somebody has fallen asleep in the afternoon reading a book in the sun. And that makes us happy.
What typically draws someone to a bed and breakfast, you know, versus a traditional hotel or a big sprawling resort?
It's interesting. A lot of our travelers are already bed and breakfast travelers. And then for us, when somebody comes in and this is their first B&B experience, the first thing they say is, you know, it's nothing like what I thought a B&B would be like. There's this stereotype, there's an idea that people have of sort of grandma's house, you know, very traditional, doilies, dark, heavy furniture, and the other thing, not a lot of privacy. They feel like for whatever reason they're going to be intruded upon, but I think that might be the case in smaller cities or sort of far out destinations, but in Asheville, bed and breakfasts are, and they have been for a long time, basically competing with the resorts and the hotels that are here. So it's like staying in a hotel, but it's an entirely personal experience. And that's kind of what I hear the most. People are wanting to experience something different, and they kind of want to be around other people. They kind of want to have, aside from coming and visiting Asheville on their own, they kind of want to have a little bit of a personal connection in the 2 or 3 days that they're staying here. So that's the real advantage of staying in a B&B, I think.
This is just a beautiful property, and it's very welcoming, and it's, you know, you feel very comfortable when you first get here, and you feel like, you know, I can come and go, and I do have my space, and if I am so inclined to sit and have coffee with the innkeeper, I could, you know, so you're accomplishing it. Well, kudos.
Thank you very much. We appreciate it.